Progress beyond a semi-final stage. Six bronze medals Denmark have had in women's doubles, but never finalists. Of course, Japan won gold in the very first World Championships back in 1977. Toganu and Ueno winning gold in Malmo in 1997. So, Naoki Fukuman and Kurumi Noha up against Kristina Pedersen and Camilla Rutiul. Quite extraordinary that this Japanese pair of Fukuman and Yano through to the semi-final stage unseeded, as indeed were three pairs unseeded in the quarter-final stage, not only this Japanese pair, but Gohara and Yu Hei-won. And of course, Ansele and Song, who put out the number one seeds, Matsutomo and Takahashi. So seven different nations involved at quarter-final stage. The two Chinese pairs had to play against each other. That was a repeat of the 2011 and 2014 World Championship final. And to consider, they had to meet in the quarter-final stage. Well, as you can see, four different nations in the semi-finals, and that's only the third time that that's happened. Here are the Danes. Kristina Pedersen and Camilla Rutiul. Of course, they were bronze medalists 2 years ago in Guangzhou. The European champions, the two-time European champions. The left and right-handed combination. Naoko Fukuman and Kurumi Yonao of Japan. Here they are, unseeded. In fact, they're only the fourth Japanese pair on the world ranking. And on the Super Series, the elite tier of tournaments, the 12 tournaments throughout the year, they have never progressed past a second round. And here they are in a World Championship semi-final. Extraordinary run. They've beaten three seeded pairs to be here in the semi-final, so they've more than deserved their semi-final berth. But my goodness, who would have predicted prior to the start of the Total World Championships here in Jakarta that this Japanese pair would be in the semi-final stage? Wainaina of Indonesia is our umpire for this one. Gilles Calais of France is our service judge. Now, just look how much taller the Danes are than the Japanese players, towering above them. Well, I suppose if you go on the seedings and you go on world rankings, you have to rate the Danes as favourites for this. But when you consider the pairs that the Japanese pair have beaten en route, I'm not so sure about it. But there is Kristina Pedersen, 29 years of age, from Aalborg in North Jutland, number four in the world ranking. They have been as high as two. Total of 46 weeks as world number twos. And as I say, they are trying to create history. Never before has a Danish pair been in the final of a World Championships in the women's doubles discipline. Two finals this year from eight tournaments played. They won in the Malaysian Grand Prix gold and the German Grand Prix gold as well. And when we look at their results through to today's semi-final, well, they had a bye in the first round. The last two matches against Korean pairings, the number 11 seeds Lee Soo-hee and Shin Sung-chan in the third round, and Go and Yu in the quarter-final. All of their matches, as you can see, in two straight games. It has been very impressive, especially in their quarterfinal yesterday. I thought the Danes looked in tremendous form. So to their opponents, Fukuman, 23 years of age, 17 in the world ranking, have been one place higher, spent 1 week on the 25th of June earlier this year, 16 in the world, and Ayel now 22 years of age. Well, it's a fairy tale path for them and tournament, and the fairy tale may continue a little further. In the second round, they beat the number 12 seeds, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei of Malaysia.
Ready to play.
In the third round, they disposed of the number 2 seeds, the identical twin sisters of Liu Ying and Liu Yu. Saved a match point at 19-20 in the second game, and actually had to come back from 8-14 down in the third. In the quarterfinal, they disposed of the former bronze medalists from 2011, Joanna Gutter and Ashwini Ponapa, the number 13 seeds. Now, as you were seeing, they have played each other once previously. That was the final of the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold earlier this year. 14-14, it was pretty convincing, wasn't it? So, Steen, you know the Danish girls very well indeed. They obviously will know this is perhaps the biggest chance they'll ever have of creating this record.
It is. They had another big chance of really excelling at the big stage, and that was the Olympics, and they got really, really nervous. So that's, of course, the big question mark here.
Yeah, well, that's a big part of sport, isn't it? It's not just your physical capabilities and your tactical awareness. It's who can deal with the pressure. Of course, in the Olympic Games you're talking about, they beat the eventual gold medalists in the group, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, and that really sort of upset the apple cart in many ways.
On my right, Christina Pedersen, Camilla Littlejuhl, Denmark. And on my left, Naoko Fukuman, Kurumi Yunao, Japan. Christina Pedersen to serve, to Naoko Fukuman. Love all. Play.
So the women's doubles semi-final. The number 4 seeds from Denmark, Pedersen and Ruti Yul, up against Fukuman and Yama. She's an interesting character, Fukuman. Bronze medalist in the women's singles in the World Junior Championships in Guadalajara. And lost out to a certain Rachel Intanon, who of course became world champion in 2013, having beaten the quarterfinal, the reigning world champion, Carolina Marin. Of course, she wasn't reigning world champion at the time, but having beaten Carolina Marin in the singles, now concentrating in the doubles. And that's gone long, and that's very, very interesting. Not going for power there.
Power will only be used against you against the Japanese women's doubles. They're really good in the defense. We can see they also try to sort of park Camilla at backcourt.
Gonna go wide.
Yeah.
Oh, she's taken it. Yeah, so take a bit of pace. The 3 hard smashes there from Pedersen. Came back with interest.
They're not getting anywhere closer to winning the rally.
That is over.
By smashing from that position.
Three.
is actually a defensive position in women's doubles, in my opinion, smashing from between the two backcourt lines.
Well, we talked about the fact the Danes may be a little bit nervous because they'll know this is a big chance, but of course the Japanese pair also, I mean, so they are underdogs, and every time they've played, they have played as underdogs throughout this tournament.
Yeah, and they of course must be totally surprised with this achievement so far. And we often see that when you have this new achievement, that it's actually easier going all the way through. We saw it with Carolina Marin last year,
yeah,
going on to win the title, because you never expected it, so you don't really get to think about what is actually happening here.
Well, just proving your point.
There's another twist to this match, because on the coaching chair is Danish national coach Lars Ure. But it's normally Kenneth Jonassen coaching these two girls. Unfortunately, he's fallen ill and is unable to even sit on the chair.
But they will work with Lars Ure on a daily basis. I mean, it's not totally alien, but I appreciate your point.
Clever tactics by the Japanese. We can see they're just lifting on the short service, not attempting anything. That's wide.
Yeah, good judgment.
Six, four.
Idea. Can't change the pace. But it's interesting, Stina. I mean, I think back over the last decade or so, and perhaps even longer ago than that, and women's doubles was very defensive. And I thought with the Gerfei and Gu Jun, I thought they changed women's doubles. They were very aggressive on court. I think that Wang Xiao Li and Yu Young, twice world champions, they were very aggressive in their style. I think most of the Chinese pairs are pretty aggressive. And here we have a Japanese pair that seems to have reverted back to the old style of play of just really wanting to defend and lift the shuttle.
Yeah, but you have to apply the tactics that can get you a victory.
Yeah,
and,
of course.
I would do the same if I'm playing Christina and Camilla.
Why? Because?
Because they're really strong on the front court.
Yeah, okay.
Both mixed doubles players and
both medalists.
Especially this far end of the court where they get a little bit help in their defense, the Japanese girls, to get it long enough to the backcourt of the Danes.
Yeah, you mentioned that they're very good mixed doubles players. That's an understatement, because the left-handed Camilla Rutiyul was former world champion 2009 in Hyderabad with Thomas Labor. And Christina Pedersen, not only world championship bronze medalist twice with Jochen Fischer, but also Olympic bronze medalist in the mixed doubles.
And this is a game of chicken here. Who give up first? Can the Danes keep their patience and keep on scoring? Or will they become impatient and try strange shots? The one who first deviates from the plan is very likely to lose.
Yeah.
9-5.
Good serve. Out wide. Low serve.
Well done. Good defense.
Oh, total confusion. Oh, it's called long. I think I had a little think about challenging that.
Yeah. Six, but it's risky. Nine. The ball dropping on the opponent's baseline. You can't really see it.
Yeah.
But very good defense from Fukuman there. It's not easy holding Camilla Juul off when she's coming, charging towards the net from the baseline.
Error on the defense there.
Service over.
Yo now.
10-6.
Today by Naoko Fukuman.
Yes, in fact, we used to call it the Danish swipe because Lina Kulpin used to use that,
exactly.
That backhand. Huge swing, sort of underarm, almost like a tennis player. Oh, there is Lazula. Gina.
Bless.
Well, knowing Lazula so well and knowing this Danish women's doubles combination so well, do you have any ideas on what might have been discussed?
I think probably just reinforcing the things that's been working. I think the Danes direct more of their shots towards Yonau. I think it's a good idea.
11-6.
No need to say that much. Right. Everything's been working according to the Danish plan so far.
Yeah. So, a 5-point advantage. 6-point advantage.
Draw. 6.
No, it's called just long. Well, it must have only been long by a whisker.
13-6.
Oh. confusion. Oh, goodness. Good smash in the end. But I think the Japanese pair have been told to change tactics.
Instead of playing 7-13.
Very defensively, they still play from a decent defensive starting point, but told to look for opportunities to turn it around.
Thank you.
And otherwise, it's too easy for Christina and Camilla to just patiently outmaneuver the Japanese.
Broken string or just...
I don't know. Maybe it's already soaked the grip.
Yeah, plenty of Danish fans in.
Chanting,
let's go, Denmark, let's go.
Service fault
called. Oh, service fault called.
Service over. 14-8.
Well, there's been one fault called on Christina Pedersen and now one on Kukuman.
Seems like the Japanese are backing a little bit in their defense, and that's not a good idea. We'll have a much harder time turning it around. Got to stand your ground. It's in.
Service over, 9-15.
Oh, that's wide of the center line. That's well left.
Service over, 16-9.
Even close to going out. I don't know if she changed her mind.
60.
Maybe a little off balance.
Yeah. Hard to move in that direction and hit the shot Camilla's trying here.
Service over. 17. 10.
That was good. Overdone it.
Service over. 11-17.
Well, it's been 24 years since a European pair were in the final of the World Championships. You have to go back to Copenhagen in 1991. Swedish combination, Christine Magnusson and Maria Benson reached the final. Well, it's far too early for us to be saying that another European pair could reach the final.
You're now, sir.
Yeah, they're in the wrong formation. Japanese pair. Yonao is serving, not Fukuman. What a return.
Yeah, they had quite a few lucky shots on the net, the Danes.
18-11.
Quite close to this first game.
Opportunity.
12-18.
Well, first one, I thought it was a little bit awkward and wasn't really in position to play the hard kill, but that second one, ooh, she'll be annoyed with herself. Oru to you for making the error on that net shot.
Another net coach, service return.
Service over. 19-12.
2 points away from this opening game. Another serve out wide. Mixing it up well. Slight hesitation between the two Japanese players, and that hesitation forced the error. And now 8 game point opportunities for the Danes, Pedersen and Rutiul. History. One game to the goods. 21-12. Yeah. Job half done. But they mustn't think like that. Still a long way to go. The Japanese pair we've seen earlier in the tournament have come back from a game deficit. They've come back from match points down. 21 minutes, 21-12. Well, the Japanese coach is still working with their players, even though the 20-second warning has been delivered. And that is normally a sign for the coaches to leave and the players to return to court.
First come court now.
Interesting now whether the Danes can be even more dangerous in attack or the Japanese can get their defense going. Playing up against the wind, the Japanese now, but it's also a little bit dangerous because Danes are getting help in their attack.
Second game. Lovell. Play.
Oh, goodness. Just going to leave that. Took it about shoulder height in the end, which is all.
One. Love.
Let's go wrong, that's good judgment from Christina Pedersen.
Service over, 1-0.
And very tense, especially Fukuman jumping up and down, trying to loosen up in between the rallies.
Yeah, that's a good smash.
Service over, 2-1.
You are now cross court smash across the body. That's clever. Body language, there was almost a little childlike sort of stamp of the feet after she made that error there. She's definitely nervous. Fukuman.
This is what the Chinese, the Japanese have to be wary about, that they don't get the right height and length on their lifts, because then the Danes' attack is really, really lethal.
Open court.
That is over. 3-0.
Well, of all the players on court, 31-year-old Camilla Ruta-Yul is the player that's already won a world title, but Just because you've done that doesn't make it any easier to win another. You can still feel the nerves.
That's very well left by Kristina Pedersen. It's against the wind in every aspect. The drift along the court and the side drift. But still out. Speed up a little bit now because I feel that they're in a good rhythm.
Speed up in between rallies, you mean, or yeah. Speed up in the rally?
Both, if possible.
Okay.
But they're mostly in between rallies.
Yeah.
And if I were Japanese, I would really try to towel down.
Oh!
Yes, good smash.
Seven, three.
I guess the Danes won't mind a new shuttle, because a new shuttle is a fast shuttle.
Yeah, and they have no intention of clearing or lifting.
Yeah.
Service over, 4-7.
They're about to get Camilla Yule going. She's been challenging for it with some raids towards the net. She's been a little bit unlucky, but if she gets even more confidence, she's going to be a hard player to beat. It's wide.
Yeah. Good judgment from you, Steve.
Yeah, thank you. I was just about to mention it.
I also get the impression, not only the fact that Camilla Urutiul is really gaining in confidence, but I get the impression that the Japanese pair are beginning to run out of ideas.
Yeah. They put their defense long, and that's really worrying on this side. Let's see if they can make a comeback now.
Yeah, they need to start closing this gap down a bit, don't they, before the mid-game interval.
Too short.
Yeah, that's well left. A couple of serves that Kristina Pedersen has left, and she's been wise to do so. Coming forward for the kill.
Service over. Six.
Yeah, did well.
Thank you.
Oh, great interception by the left hander. Oh, clever. That's a good rally.
Very important rally for the Japanese girls.
Seven, ten.
It's a lot about fight now for Yunao and Fukuman. Every point they can get off the Danes will be valuable.
Yeah, that was quite considerable time on the timeout there, considering we're potentially only 1 point away from the big game interval. Well, that's nice to see the two Danish girls communicating, smiling at each other. Indeed, we are at the mid-game interval.
11,
a four-point advantage for the number four seeds from Denmark. 34 minutes into the match. Okay, over our cup of tea tonight, you can tell me. The Japanese, the little ritual there, which is very pleasant. They just give a little bow to the court before returning, all the court officials.
Eleven, seven.
So can the Danes push home and create history. Point by point.
12-7.
And the Japanese, they need to sort of keep close to the Danes in order to invoke final nerves. Can't afford too big a gap.
Well,
13-7.
Service over 8-13. Well, if Ruta Yul had managed to control that, the Japanese player would have been in trouble. I mean, for the cross-court smash, it does either have to be a winner. It's a dangerous tactics to use.
9-13.
This is one of the situations where you're allowed to make mistakes as an attacking pair, but not too many.
Yes, and who's making the errors at the moment? the last three rallies, has been reaching yours. Smash too flat and going long.
Yeah, she can just, use angle instead.
Yeah,
that's right. Just as efficient.
And what you were advocating from the start anyway, that if you just go for power, the Japanese pair will feed off that. Well, they've done exactly the same thing. Can you believe
that
it? Flat smash, long. Well, that is a bit of a reprieve, I have to say, for the Danes. Just felt that they were feeling a little bit nervous. And
yeah.
Oh, that's well played from Fukuman.
Service over 11-14.
Yeah, apologises for hitting her opponent, but it was a clever shot. And I think there's a couple of very important points coming up right now. Good channel attack, the final shot for the Japanese pair, right in between the two Danes, both going for it and getting in each other's way.
They're moving too much back, the Danes. They won't turn it around this way. Need to come forward in their defense.
I thought she deserved to put it away. It was so loose. Look at this. Popped up. That low serve. By Fukuman. Well, I noticed the Danes immediately asking to tell down. Perhaps just recompose the thoughts. Oh, nearing crunch time.
That's
a good flick serve. From that far end of the court, that's very good.
Yeah, and a big miss by Fukuman.
16-12.
Yeah, you said they had to come forward. Positive on defense.
17-12.
4 points away from creating history. The number four seeds from Denmark. Women's double is the only event where Denmark has yet to win a World Championship gold medal. Can they dare to dream? Good work from Fukuman.
over.
This is where I'd expect 17. The games to become a little bit tensed. Yeah, really close, but not a comforting lead.
Yeah. So the Japanese pair mustn't gift anything away. They must put pressure on the Danes. Yeah. We were right against them.
14,
that looked a nervous
17.
Shot to me from Ruta Yolt.
Service over 18-14.
The disappointment from you now very obvious. Ruta Yolt was asked to retie a shoelace.
19-14.
Well, she's done it quite quickly, in fairness to her. 2 points away from the final. Good serve. And a great interception. It's match point opportunities for the Danes. 2014, 6 match point opportunities. Oh, record. Missed it. There's the nerves you were talking about, Steve. Oh, yeah, she knows it.
No one was close to that one.
But surely that sort of error gives heart to the Japanese pair because they will register that the Danes are nervous. But is it too much of a gap to close down? In the women's doubles, it's the Danes who will contest the final tomorrow. What a performance by Christina Pedersen and Camilla Ruta Yolt. The moment of victory, the shuttle goes long, and the celebration. But the celebration cannot be carried through tonight. There's still another match to play. There's an opportunity for Denmark to complete their set. A gold medal in all five disciplines. They will have 11-12, 21-15 in 46 minutes. Excitement we've had today here on semi-finals day, and we're only halfway through. That's absolutely extraordinary, almost 7 hours. Our next semi-final is the second of the women's singles, then we've got the second of the men's singles, and then we've got men's doubles, women's doubles, and our last match tonight will be the second of the men's doubles. Oh my goodness me. We've already seen in the first two single semi-finals, the defending champions safely booked their berth in tomorrow's final. And the next up, of course, is women's singles. Linda Wenny Fanatry, the home player, unseeded against the number two seed, Saina Nehwal of India. Now, like the men's singles, and in fact like four of the five disciplines, we've got four different nations involved at semi-final stage, and that is the first time that has ever happened. It's not the first time it's happened in men's singles or the first time it's happened in women's singles. This is the third consecutive time we've had four different nations involved at semi-final stage. And to think that a few years ago there were people criticizing, saying that this women's singles discipline was dominated by China. I can tell you that for the first time ever since China has participated in the World Championships, they will not have a women's singles.